Hello, folks. This is Quinn, that snazzy iPhone guy, and today is Triple T Terminal Tip Tuesday. Now, today we have a very unique and very cool little modification that allows you to stick dashboard widgets onto your desktop. Now, as a little bit of a background and premise, you're probably thinking, ah, dashboard, that sucks. Well, dashboard was initially released on 10.4 Tiger back in 2005. It was one of the big fancy changes to the operating system, and it brought with it the ability to put widgets onto your Mac. Now, unfortunately, Apple didn't execute this very well, and they didn't make the widgets very widely available, or at least they didn't advertise it so. So it was a very underrated and underused utility on the Mac. I actually went so far as to disable all of dashboard. There's a terminal command, which will be next week's terminal command, and it allows you to disable dashboard altogether. You hit the dashboard key, nothing happens. It's basically a dead application. And I enable this for all six of my Macs because it was annoying, it was pestersome, it was cumbersome, it always pop up, you do weird things, and I didn't like it. Additionally, it sucked resources. Not a ton, but enough to make me go, okay, this does not need to be on here. However, when I bought my 13-inch MacBook, I tried dashboard. I gave it one more shot, and I downloaded applications and widgets that were not the ones that were default, but ones that you're able to get from apple.com/downloads. It turns out there's a lot of freeware widgets that are actually really amazingly cool. I just didn't know about them because Apple never told me, go here to get them. And I think that's why a lot of people don't use dashboard, is they don't know that there are cool widgets out there for it. So I want to show you how to put dashboard widgets onto your desktop. Now, if you're using a 13-inch MacBook Pro, it's probably not the best option because you don't have a lot of real estate. However, if you have a big 24 or 27-inch iMac and you have some room, be willing to do it. I'm actually enabled it on my MacBook because I have an external monitor upstairs that's 22 inches, and that becomes my main display, and then the laptop itself becomes an additional display. So I've decided to put all my widgets on this, whereas my main work is on my big display when it's hooked up through the mini display port. So if you have a big computer, if you have some room, this is a really cool utility and really cool modification. I'm going to show you how to enable it on your Mac in a couple minutes, but I'm going to kind of demo it first. So we're going to launch dashboard here. And I have a bunch of really cool widgets. This one tracks all your packages and lets you know how many days until it's going to be delivered. This takes you to a random website. This gives you a total overview of your battery, uptime, fans, all that good stuff. iStat Nano. I use iStat menus religiously and love it. And this is no exception. I have snow levels right here. I'm a huge skier, so I want to see how much POW came in overnight. This is actually a stock widget that is pretty good. The same goes for the weather one. This is a very cool widget, which I may have to do an application review all by itself. It basically snags lyrics for all of the songs in your iTunes library instantaneously. Right when you play it, the lyrics pop up on this widget. It's really cool. Mighty Monitor displays to you the battery life in your Bluetooth mouse and keyboard and all that other good stuff. This will allow you to take more fine screenshots than the integrated display and the integrated system, which Mac OS X carries. And this is a real-time weather display of the whole earth. So it's really a pretty cool little utility. And dashboard, when executed and when used well, can be pretty powerful. So let's say I really, really like this iStat Nano widget. I like how you can see how much battery you have and how much cycles you've had, how much time remaining, because that doesn't, it's not provided in the stock battery widget or the stock battery thing in the menu bar. So what we're going to do is we are going to place this onto our desktop. All you need to do is kind of hold it and drag it around for a minute. Now that it's been selected, you need to hit your dashboard key or F12. Either or will work. Dashboard will go away, but your widget will stay on your dashboard. On your desktop. So you can stick this wherever you want. Unfortunately, and this is where the big display is necessary, if you open a window, your widget is going to stay on top of it. There's no way to sync that to the background. You can't affix that to the desktop. So it's always floating above all your applications, which is why it will kind of need its own quadrant of space. Otherwise, you're going to have conflicting menus here, and it just doesn't get very pretty. So you want to stick it up in the corner or somewhere like that. But basically, that's what it is, and it allows you to fully use your widgets directly from your desktop. It's cool. You can do as many as you want. It really doesn't matter. Once again, you just hold, you drag, and then you press the dashboard key and it'll pop up. And then when you're ready to put it back, you can put it back as well. Hold it, press the dashboard key, and then you drop it into place. So it's a very cool terminal tip, and you can only do it through terminal. So this is how you're gonna do it. You are going to go into terminal right now. If you don't know where terminal is, you're going to want to launch your Finder, go to applications, go down to utilities, and then you're going to want to go to terminal. You can also do a spotlight search for it, and that will work as well. Now, what you're going to type into this, and you need not type it because I do have it pasted down below. So just copy and paste, but it's defaults right, com.apple.dashboard, dev mode, yes, in big capital letters. If you want to disable it, you can do dev mode, no, in capital letters, and then it will go away. You're then going to press enter. It doesn't look like you did anything, but in fact you did, and it is enabled. And then you can quit terminal, and you will actually need to reboot your computer for this. There's a lot of commands where you don't have to reboot. You don't even have to log out. But this one, you will need to reboot your computer. But once you come back to it, it will reboot. The cool thing about this is it doesn't reset every time you log off or go to sleep or reboot. Every time I plug my mini DisplayPort in, that widget pops up on this screen. So it stays static, it stays in place, and it doesn't move around, and it's not finicky. It's a very cool terminal tip, which I'm actually surprised they don't let you do by default. I like it a lot. Let me know. Is this something that would work for you? Is terminal something you like using, and is dashboard something that you've ever used before? If you haven't tried it, I definitely recommend you go and give it a shot, because I do think it is pretty highly underrated. Anyways, this is Quinn, that's Nazzy iPhone Guy. Hopefully you enjoyed Terminal Tip Tuesday, and I'll see you tomorrow for another video. Thanks so much for watching, subscribe, rate, and comment, and as always, stay snazzy. See you later, folks.